Hello students, this is Krupa Lakhani. I hope you all are doing well. Today we'll learn concepts of evolution of computers. Evolution of computers. Initially, computers were used only by scientists and engineers for complex calculations and were very expensive. Nowadays, computers can be afforded by small organizations and even individuals. The term computer is derived from the word compute, which means to calculate. But a computer is not limited to perform only calculations. A computer is a versatile device that can handle different applications at the same time. The present-day computer is entirely different from the earlier devices that were invented for doing calculations. Many devices were invented, such as Pascal, Leibniz calculator, abacus. Now, what is Pascal adding machine? Blaise Pascal, a French mathematician, invented the first mechanical calculator at the age of 19 in the year 1642. It uses wheels. Numbers were displayed by rotating the wheels. It was capable of performing addition and subtraction. Now, what is Leibniz calculator? Leibniz, the famous German mathematician, improved on Pascal machine in 1671. The Leibniz calculator was a mechanical device. Apart from performing addition and subtraction, Leibniz could do even multiplication, division, and find square roots. What is abacus? Abacus was the first mechanical device for calculations developed in China. It was made up of a wooden frame with rods, each having beads. It is used for addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Generation of computers. Evolution of the present-day computer is commonly classified into generation of computers. Each new generation resulted in increase in speed, storage capacity, and reliability, and with the decrease in cost and size. The first generation computers were evolved in the year 1940 to 1956. They used vacuum tubes. Second generation computers were introduced in the year 1956 to 1963. They used transistors. Third generation computer used ICs, integrated circuits, and evolved in the year 1964 to 1971. The keyboard monitors were introduced from third generation computers. Before that, we used punch cards, paper tabs for inputs, and printouts for data output. Fourth generation computers, that is present generation computers, the present day computers which we are using, launched from the year 1972 till present. Microprocessors are used. For data input, we use keyboard, mouse, scanners, etc. For output, we use monitor, printers, speakers, etc. Fifth generation, that will be a future generation, they will use artificial intelligence, and for data input, they will use optical fiber, and they will understand human speech, and they'll recognize patterns like face patterns and complex images. There are different types of computers with respect to size, speed, storage capacity, and cost. First, microcomputers. These computers are small in size and cost less. They are usually designed for personal use. They are mainly used in homes, schools, offices, banks, etc. These computers are given different names according to their usage. Second, mini computers. These computers are bigger in size than the microcomputers. They have the large processing speed and are costlier than microcomputers. They are used in banks, universities, and in other big organizations. Mainframe computers are very powerful. They are big in size with large memory and high speed. More than 100 users can use a mainframe computer simultaneously. Mainframe computers are very expensive and are used in large business organizations, universities, banks, airline and railway ticket reservation, etc. Supercomputers are most powerful computers with a huge processing speed. These computers are used for weather forecasting, space research, satellite control, etc. Thank you. Have a nice day. Keep learning. Keep growing.